We're just going to give you a quick rundown of the categories, all right, the different games that SmartFit currently offers so you can see the power. And these categories are applicable for any one of our SmartFit systems. You'll see these. You can be used in the strike pods. It can be used in the mini, in the single, and so forth, all right? So we'll start, we'll just show a quick, so track, what is a track category? You're gonna see multiple options here in the track folder. A track category will light up one target while all the other targets are off. You're gonna see that here in just a second. So the target moves at the pace of the user. So it doesn't move until the user strikes it, all right? And so you go as fast as you can, try and get as many points as you can, and it will move at your speed, all right? Now we have a special track category. You're gonna see the different ways you can play track. You can do it with balance. Can do it with, you know, sports equipment, a strength drill, right? You're seeing that there. So the track categories, boxing gloves and so forth. There's one specific case that's called left, right, both. It's decision making. You got to choose which hand you're going to use. All right. Right hand for R, left hand for L, B for both. You're seeing an example of that now. So it's more decision making based versus just hit the target. Okay. So that's the track. All right, now I'm gonna skip seek. I'm gonna come back to seek in just a second. I'm gonna go to chase because the chase game is very similar to track where the target will move at a certain speed, or excuse me, the only one target will light up while all the other targets are off. The difference is
this type of category will turn on one target screen at a time.
It all has voice too, so you can learn. You have new staff members, you take them through the video and it'll teach you all about these categories. So this target will move at a speed that you can set as the trainer to challenge the user to go faster and faster each time. So there's two types of this category. There's the one where you just hit any target, and there's the second one, like you're seeing, where you have to avoid one target and strike the other. It's more impulse control, go, no go. How quickly can you make a decision? Can you make the correct decision? And can you meet the speed of the target? Right. So this is the chase category. Really great one for any population, because we can make it suitable for an older adult, make it suitable for that population, but also make it suitable for an experienced athlete. The seek categories will turn on all the targets with different images. So it's a bit different because we're going to see multiple options and only one of them is going to be correct. When we hit the correct answer, you'll see that the target moves. All the targets will move. We can use that with numbers for counting by ones, twos, threes, and so forth. We can adjust that. Colors, going through letters, going through the alphabet, striking the emoticon, that's smiling. So there's a variety of seek categories also that we can adjust. Now, you're noticing all nine targets light up. We can make this easier for somebody who's not able to do all nine targets. Maybe it's too overwhelming for them. We can just turn on three targets. We can turn on five targets. These are the settings that can be adjusted to make it easier or harder for somebody who's not there, not yet ready for all nine targets to light up, or maybe who doesn't want to count by high numbers, or who can count by higher numbers or skip a letter and so forth. We can make it more challenging for them.